Hey, how's it going, YouTube? I'm back in the video, and today I'm talking about what the Miami Heat need to do to beat the Los Angeles Lakers. Now, I'm beginning in this video reasons why I think that they need to do to beat the Lakers, and if you don't know, the Heat did just beat the Lakers in Game 3 to win their first game of the series, and hopefully that will get them off to tonight, and they did that with Bam Adebayo or Goran Dragic in this game. So, with that being said, I'm beginning to many things what I think the Heat could do and do better to make this series competitive, and maybe even have a chance of winning it when it's all said and done. So if you do like the video at any point, hit the like button and subscribe button. I mean the absolute world to me. And without further ado, without rambling on too much, let's get right into this video. Alright, so the first reason I have for this video is going to be that the Miami Heat cannot play small ball at all. As we just saw in Game 3 where they had played Miles Leonard and they also double-teamed Anthony Davis a lot. Well, and also Anthony Davis just didn't play good either for his standards. But I mean, you just cannot go small at all when Anthony Davis is on the court. As every time when in Game 1 when Bam Adebayo went out, Anthony Davis just took over the game and completely swung the momentum all the way to the Lakers side, and they just had no answer for him at all. I think one of the solutions to this would be playing Miles Leonard more, and we finally saw them put Myers Leonard in the game. He only played 12 minutes, but I mean, coincidentally, Anthony Davis just so happened to have his worst game of the series when Miles Leonard played. So I think he helps a ton, and I think he's the only player besides Bam Adebayo that has the size and strength to be able to even compete with Anthony Davis in the paint. So I think Myers Leonard needs to have a bigger role for this team and at least needs to get 12 minutes off the bench when Bam Adebayo does come back, because I think he's the only answer besides Bam Adebayo for Anthony Davis on this Miami Heat team. And I mean, you just cannot go small. You have no chance when Anthony Davis on the court, because he is just that good of a player. He is going to work Kelly Olynyk. He is going to work Jay Crowder. Anybody you put on him, he's going to absolutely work on a nightly basis. I know he just had an off game, but I mean, let's be honest, Anthony Davis is going to win that matchup more than he loses it. And yes, he lost it tonight, but he's probably going to drop damn near 30 points in the next matchup if they try that same strategy. So when Bam Adebayo is off the court, I think Myers Leonard has to be on the court just to deal with Anthony Davis. Now, if Anthony Davis does leave the court, then I think you can go small, because LeBron, although he is a huge threat in the paint, I don't think he's going to kill you like Anthony Davis will if you go small against them. So I think my first reason, you just cannot go small when Anthony Davis is on the court. And now my second reason for this video is going to be that they have to win the hustle game. The Miami Heat's culture is a team that hustles, is a grit and grind defensive team that's going to do anything they have to do to win. Well, in the first two games, you really didn't see that. As just take Game 1 for example. In Game 1, the Lakers shot 27 free throws while the Heat only shot 14. Well, that's just a direct representation. The Los Angeles Lakers were driving the paint and being aggressive all game, while the Miami Heat were trying to shoot threes and they just weren't making them. So the Los Angeles Lakers got more free throws, and the more free throws you get, the better chance you have winning, as those are what they are, say, free points for any team that gets the most free throws. So free throws are an extremely valuable stat. That's why players like James Harden are so successful, because of how many free points they accumulate of drawing fouls and being aggressive. So with the Lakers being aggressive as a team, getting that many free throws and having that big of an advantage in it, well, that is ginormous for a team like the Lakers. I mean, especially for them, because they are already the more talented team, so if they're more aggressive and getting more free throws, well, that's just a recipe for success. But then to make things even worse, in Game 1, the Los Angeles Lakers had 3 more assists than them, they had more steals, more blocks, and more rebounds all in Game 1, and it wasn't even close. As I mean, anytime a team has more steals, blocks, rebounds, and assists, you just stand no chance of winning that game, because they're being less selfish, you're getting more teammates involved, and they're playing better defense. There's nothing you can do to win if you're getting that bad. But the biggest stat that is just absolutely ridiculous is the rebounding in Game 1, where they got out-rebounded 54-36. Now, I know outside of Bam Adebayo, you don't have very many big men to out-rebound Anthony Davis, but it's not like Anthony Davis got all 54 of those rebounds, and it's not like Bam Adebayo got all 36 of the Heat's. A rebound is a purely hustle stat, and you just have to want to rebound. Like, that's all it is. Now, yes, maybe the Lakers will always lead that rebounding stat because they do have bigger bodies and more of them, but they should never lead by damn near 20 rebounds when you're a hustling team and your culture is doing anything it takes to win. Rebounding, like I said earlier, is purely hustle. So people like Jimmy Butler, Bam Adebayo, Tyler Herro, Duncan Duncan Robinson, Jay Crowder, and Kelly Olynyk, and players like that have to crash the boards, and they have to get rebounds. Jimmy Butler said it himself after this Game 3 win, you have to rebound to stand a chance. You cannot give the Lakers extra possessions. And I mean, he literally said it in the interview that they finally started rebounding, and well, what happened? They ended up winning the game. You have to out-hustle a team that you're not as talented than. Because I think, no doubt, everybody knows the Lakers are the way more talented team than the Miami Heat. But the Miami Heat, what they have is heart and hustle on their side, and if you're not going to do that, you're not going to win. Because you cannot be less talented and not hustle. Just, you can't do that and be a successful team. And I think the Heat finally figured that out, and that is a big reason why they were able to win Game 3. And now my third and final reason is going to be that they have to be the better three-point shooting team. As all season and all playoff long, the Los Angeles Lakers have been a worse three-point shooting team than the Miami Heat, and the Miami Heat have not just been a good three-point shooting team, they have been one of the best three-point shooting teams in the NBA. So, I mean, if that's one of your biggest strengths, you have to be able to be better than the Lakers at that, especially when that is one of the Lakers, not weaknesses, but weaker points of the team. So, I mean, anytime in like Game 1 or really this whole series where you only make 31% of your threes and you let the Lakers make 39.5% of their threes, well, you're going to lose that game. I mean, the Lakers are not a good three-point shooting team. So when they're shooting 40% from the three-point line pretty much and you're damn near shooting only 30% shooting from the three-point line, you're going to lose. Especially when you combine you're getting out-hustled and out-talented and out-coached in some aspects, well, there's just nothing you're going to be able to do to win that game. And now, yes, you can rely on Jimmy Butler having a 40-point triple-double every night, which is not going to happen, but I mean, if you're relying on Jimmy Butler to do that every night, that's just not winning basketball. Now, yes, Jimmy Butler was able to do it tonight, and they actually played pretty well around him. Tyler Herro scored a little bit. They were getting rebounds. They were hustling, and that's what Miami Heat need to do. So hopefully when they get Goran Dragic and Bam Adebayo, they keep the hustling going. Jimmy Butler can still get you around 20, 30 points a game. Bam Adebayo can bring in his 20 and 10 rebounds. Goran Dragic can be the facilitator and be the point guard they need. And then, boom, maybe the Miami Heat can make this a competitive series. So in conclusion, if they can just be able to stay big when Anthony Davis isn't in there, go small when they can, and then also if they can win the hustle game and shoot the three better, they legit have a chance to win and or at least make the series somewhat competitive, at least not what it was the first two games. Now, the only reason I think Game 3 could be a fluke is because, I mean, one, I think LeBron's about to come out pissed off in Game 4 because one, Tyler Herro made that face, and so far, anytime anyone's done anything celebration-wise against LeBron this playoff series in the bubble, well, it just hasn't been very fair. I mean, you have Jamal Murray, he tried to dance, that they lost in five. Damian Lillard danced, they lost in five. Russell Westbrook tried to talk some shit, they lost in five. So if that's any pattern, if it's going to keep up, well, Jimmy Butler and Tyler Herro did some shit, so chances are they will probably lose in five. But if they are able to do hustle and do all these things, hopefully they can keep it competitive and hopefully they can make it a fun series. But unfortunately, guys, that's going to be it for this video. So comment below. Do you agree with me? Do you think the Miami Heat can do this? Do you think they can make competitive? Do you think they can win? I want to hear your thoughts in the comment section below. And if not, and if you did like the video at any point, hit like button and subscribe button to mean the absolute world to me. All glory to God. Hope you have a blessed day. God bless day. So you need to have a blessed day. See you in the next video. Goodbye. Boo. Blah.